Thanks for joining us this Monday morning. Sydney's COVID outbreak has turned to heartbreak, sadly claiming the life of a 90-year-old woman.
Yeah, she lived in the city's southwest, caught the virus from a family member, and passed away just hours after testing positive. We're joined now by Liverpool Mayor Wendy Waller. Mayor, good morning to you. Thank you for your time this morning. This is just so sad, isn't it?
It is. It's always tragic to lose a family member, and this is no different.
I guess this was what they were all worried about, wasn't it, for some time in the lead-up to the weekend, big families and someone bringing the virus into a family.
Well, when you have extended families and generations under one roof, you know, you will pose a threat to the contagiousness nature of this vaccine. Dr. Chance made it very clear from day one, this is an extremely contagious vaccine, virus, and it even affects children, and that's the thing that really concerned me.
Just looking over the weekend, I'm sure that the bad weather sort of helped matters, but everyone seemed to be doing the right thing. What did you make of the increased police presence in your region?
Well, the perception is from the general public, and I've had a lot of people talk to me about it, by obviously on the internet, that they're very concerned that we're being singled out, and that we know from previous lockdowns people complied. We do understand this is a bit different in the sense it's family groupings and they're trying to stop the mobility between households. We understand that, but people are complying and the police have said that quite clearly. So I think we need the health response rather than the police response. If we've got an extra 100 health workers in our local area giving out the vaccines rather than this, I think we'd get a better outcome.
So if you live there and you're a constituent, how do you feel about an increased police presence? There was even talk about the army coming in.
I think it's an overkill, frankly, and I don't think it's totally necessary. People are doing the right thing, and what we really need is to be concentrating on a health outcome, not a sort of police and order outcome. People are health at risk here. Finding them, if people are being really silly, they do deserve what they get. Mm. But overall, we know from past experience and also current experience, people are generally complying. So we do need that health response. We need people to set up in local areas like schools or in local community centres and get the jab out so people can actually get the vaccination and go home without travelling kilometres across LGAs.
Wendy, as you know, there's been a lot of discussion this morning about that very confronting ad which shows a woman struggling to breathe to encourage people to get vaccinated. What did you make of it?
Well, first, I think it establishes the seriousness of it, and I think people will get that message, which is important. But I think the most important thing is with that ad, they need to have a lot of localised places for people to go to get the vaccination so they can get it without having to wait a very long time.
How's the uptake in your community with the vaccination and also the testing process?
It is what it is. It's slow because people will actually go to where they need to go to get it, which is often a GP in a local area, not Liverpool, or the hospital, which is an issue now because of the fortunate death. But it is about making sure vaccines are accessible to people. It's not people being accessible to the vaccines. It should be the other way around. We should be trying to make it as accessible as the testing stations.
So you're saying it's not easy to get a vaccine in your area?
No, it's not. People will actually have to find a GP. And if you go to Dr. Google, which everybody does, you can see, especially in Liverpool, there's not a large amount of venues that are actually doing it. I know we have the hub at Homebush, but, I mean, we're a family. We're not going to get in a car and travel to Homebush to be vaccinated. I've heard they're going to open a hub in Campbelltown. That's another distance. So why aren't we breaking it down to smaller areas like, as I said, local schools? There's a school in every suburb. And they've done that before for polio, for everything else that we've had in the past. And schools are very accessible. People know where their local school is. And most people could probably walk to it and walk home, which would mean they're outside in the fresh air.
Mayor, we can't have you. We can't have you on the program making sense. That's just not going to do.
No,
it's an outrageous idea you're putting forward.
Thanks for your time today, and best of luck.
Thanks, Wendy.
Stay safe.
You too.
Stay safe.